Greetings, Spencer. So today we're going to go through the first messer I ever got. So this is the SGT messer. This is specifically the longer version, the Grosses messer. I think it's marketed as on the website. So there will be a couple parts of this review, the sword, what it's like, what it feels like, some problems with it, and the regular stuff. But then I'll also talk a little bit about, you know, what it's for, because it's, you know, it's not just a regular looking messer. Sort of what it's for and what, you know, the reason why you might want this as opposed to other types of messers, or why you might not want a messer like this. So, messer, if you don't know, means knife, and so Langusmesser or long knife. Lots of reasons why these were made historically. Won't get into it now. So this long knife by SGT specifically, we'll start off with the blade. Has a good thick tip, which is nice. You can see there's very little profile taper on the blade itself, so it is mostly a rectangle all the way. It does have a good chunk of distal taper, but the edge stays pretty thick most of the way. It only gets very thin to 2 millimeters at the very end. So I definitely don't feel comfortable running my hands just up and down the blade because it is reasonably thin, but compared to some other training messers, it has a reasonably thick edge for most of the blade. The flex is good. It definitely is stiffer than a long sword. Just, you know, the shorter the blade, the harder it will thrust. But it's definitely a good enough blade. It is actually slightly bent. You might be able to make it out a little bit at the tip. That was actually from a time where all I did was, the person went to cut up my sword, I just changed through, kept my sword still, and they just impaled themselves on it with all their weight and bent the sword. Didn't quite survive staying completely straight there, but it's straight enough that it's not that big a deal. The point of balance is roughly 3 inches, so that's a good point of balance for it. It is able to move, but still maintain, you know, enough blade impact. But overall, it is a very light blade. Overall, it's about 2 pounds. But because it is quite thin at the tip, reasonably thick at the bottom, it moves really, really fast. You're able to swing it around really fast. The handle is a good size. You're generally able to hook with the bottom still. The cross guard is quite small. A lot of other messers being made do have longer crosses. That really helps with a lot of, I have gotten hit with the hand a lot in this, with the blade just making it underneath. But again, lots were made with smaller crosses. The handle is quite a thick cylinder, so it is good for gloves, good to hold. I don't have too much trouble switching to the thumb on the blade in it. However, because the blade is so thin, in order to do it quickly, I have to push on the cross guard, which is not ideal if I'm wanting to come in for a squinting cut or something, because then my thumb's just going to get hit. So it's because of the blade dimensions, it's just not easy to always switch to a thumb on the blade safely. And the leather wrap on it actually is a little bit slippery. That can be fixed easily with, you know, adding stuff onto it, but I definitely see as people are cutting, their hand slips further and further down it. So that's something to just be aware of. If you're noticing your hand slipping down, you know, do something about that. You're gonna get less and less control over it. And this is where we'll get to the noggle. So one of the important things about picking a messer is you do need to look at the noggle shape, because what I had to learn from this sword is that they will not just work with any glove, depending how they're made. So this noggle specifically is directly straight and then tips down. Other noggles sometimes go up a bit and then come down. Some are straight, they're all different. But I'm just going to show a couple gloves that we use. Some work, some don't. So here's one of our Red Dragon pairs. You'll notice if I switch to thumb on the blade, I then can't switch back. The noggle gets stuck on the glove, and it just, if I want to switch back, I have to lift it up in order to go back. this red dragon, actually the plate has fallen out at the very corner. And so this one actually can get back a little bit easier, but it's still not incredibly easy, but a little bit better with this one. With a coning, I find the Naggle gets stuck on the knuckle and doesn't actually make it over in sparring. Again, I have to push it up or come out of combat before and turn it myself. Now with a regular Spes Heavy, I am able to switch back and forth, probably the easiest out of these gloves. However, I find it really difficult to use one-handed swords with a full mitt. I just find it really frustrating. I need that finger dexterity to actually pull it back, because sometimes sparring like this, I find I just have to say, okay, I can't actually switch my grip again until I back out of combat, and then I can just inch it over to the side. Now this is a Spes Heavy that I've cut, and this one I can actually switch quite a lot easier back and forth. However, this has a major problem of pretty much it consistently gets stuck underneath the plate. Because it's a little bit looser, a little bit more mobile, every time I switch the thumb on the blade, it gets caught underneath. And so that gets really problematic. A sparring glove does in general make it. I think a slightly bigger sparring glove would have a harder time. So after seeing all that, I would just have really liked it if this Naggle was just straight all the way. That would have just made it so I didn't have to worry about what gloves I'm wearing and have all these little issues with gloves. It would have been really nice to just not have those problems. That's why I'm a huge fan of ring guards on as the Naggle, because ring guard just doesn't have a problem with that at all, and so I appreciate those just a lot easier when using gloves. Now there are ways to still make a Naggle a little bit more usable this semester that I'll do in a different video, but you can see it actually goes up from the cross and then comes down even further. So this still has issues, it's not perfect, but it's at least a little bit easier getting over it because your hand sort of nestles in between it. So that's just a bit of my gripes with the Naggle. But what does the sword feel like? So this is essentially a Feder. This is, you know, Feder Messer. It's not super representative of a Messer blade. If we show this synthetic Messer blade, you can see it is significantly thicker, and also significantly thicker at the tip. And this is a steel Messer that I also use. And so these feel like completely different swords. They don't really feel at all in the same category of weapon. This isn't super representative of most long knives, so why would you want this Messer? Well, there is a couple of reasons why you might like this, and there are other Messers from other companies that are made in sort of this specification, as sort of a safer tournament Feder design, as opposed to a heavier blunt Messer. So this has significantly less weight at the tip, and so it hits, there's not even a comparison, this thing hits so much lighter than those other Messers. They can bend reasonably the same, but generally this will bend more than most training Messers. It's also a lot longer than a lot of the other Messers out there, or a reasonable amount longer. This thing, you don't have to choose between it being a sword and a shield. This can be both. You can make a squinting cut and always hit them, because this blade is significantly longer than an arm. It will always reach your opponent. I made a video about that called Blade Length, When Does It Matter? You can check that one out if you want to see more of what I'm talking about with that. So this Messer is going to be light enough for you to, you know, practice movements very quickly. You're not going to get strain on wrist as you will with other Messers. This Messer isn't going to pull you down, and it's also not going to hit too hard. And also, because this Messer is a good chunk longer, it's pretty much just an arming sword with a Naggle. So you can use it with other types of weapons. If you're wanting to do a lot of mixed sparring against side sword, rapiers, long swords, sword and buckler, whatever you want to do, you're not going to feel at a huge disadvantage. You're just going to have a, you know, a slightly shorter, you know, a touch shorter blade and less of a cross guard. So you're going to be able to still be somewhat competitive and be able to have fun sparring against all other types of weapon systems and not just be at a big disadvantage the whole time, where you have to try really hard in order to get anything done. So there are definitely reasons for it, but if what I've sort of started leaning towards, we're wanting to practice more with masters that are under the length of the arm, that really force you to have to choose between it being a weapon and a shield, where it can't just easily be both, and also use stuff that's a bit more representative, where we can't just swing it around easily because it's a lot of restrain, and so we're using stuff that's a bit broader and more representative of historical masters, but they are significantly heavier, will hit harder, generally the edge is thinner, so they'll find gaps in your HEMA armor easier, and so something like this is still a good choice if you're wanting to have something that's lighter and faster to just use in a multitude of scenarios. He does also make a version of this that's just shorter, so you can also have one that is smaller than the arm, so it's still purely a sort of self-defense, just multi-purpose tool, as opposed to something that's, this is a bit more with this longer blade that's closer to an arming sword, it is something that can is a bit more weapon-like. So that was a lot more rant-like, I guess, for this messer, but yeah, is a good messer. I've had it for a long time and used it against lots of different weapons. This will be the weapon that I like to use against just other weapon systems. And so it moves fast, is agile, and isn't going to hit very hard. Thanks for watching. Keep studying. Keep practicing.